Hi, my name is Maximilian Moldaschel, a senior multi-asset strategist in the research team at MAQS, and today I'll take you through the key points of our latest publication. Investors are grappling with another wave of China-US trade war angst, and markets have suffered from renewed volatility in May. After briefly posting new highs in April, global equities fell back again, with the S&P 500 a bit more than 5% lower from its April peak at the time of recording. In fact, investors have shifted their focus several times in recent months. As shown in this chart using news headline data, recession fears dominated in Q4 last year when macroeconomic data weakened considerably, giving way to euphoria as the Fed paused its policy tightening, only for fresh worries about a deepening China-US trade war to come back again. Now, while supportive Goldilocks conditions are still in place, we have always characterized the current Goldilocks environment as a fragile one. In other words, one that could be destabilized quite easily. This begs the question whether the probability of a synchronized slowdown scenario has increased. To us, the answer here is not really. We have long argued that broader deglobalization trends are at the heart of the trade war between the US and China, and that there are issues extending way beyond trade in the struggle for global power. Put differently, the medium to long-term trend is for a reversal of the globalization forces of prior decades. But equally, there are shorter-term cyclical gyrations around this deglobalization trend, as shown schematically in this chart. At times, tensions will ease, as they did in Q1 this year, and then rise again, as was the case in 2018, and again recently. As such, we are not surprised to see a flare-up in tensions. If anything, this has given us an entry point for buying DM equities, which are less exposed to trade war risks than other assets. In fact, as shown here, the market is actually differentiating substantially with assets more exposed to risk, such as emerging market equities and the Chinese yuan, having underperformed, with broader developed market and US equities holding up better. On a sectoral basis too, semiconductors have underperformed meaningfully. We also note that DM economic trends have continued to recover from the Q4 soft patch, with especially the US economy looking strong domestically. In terms of our asset allocation, having been strategically neutral on equities for some time, we increased our market risk by going long DM equities into the latest correction. Our base case of fragile Goldilocks is one that is conducive to buying dips, and we hold a cautiously constructive view on the eventual resolution of China-US trade tensions. Elsewhere, we continue to believe that the dovish stance by the Fed and other major central banks should drive a surge for yield dynamic, and we thus still favor being long carry assets. We are currently long EM hard currency debt, which enjoys high carry and is protected from currency weakness. And European REITs remain on our radar as an alternative source of carry. Finally, we believe that building robust portfolios and holding diversification trades remains absolutely key at this stage of the cycle. We hold several portfolio diversifiers specifically geared around the risk of an escalation in China-US tensions, including a long CAC versus DAX RV trade in equities, where the latter is more exposed to trade war risks, and a long dollars versus Asian FX trade, which correlates with dollar China and has done well as China-US tensions mounted lately. More broadly, we also still like being long in 5-year US bonds versus 5-year German bonds, a trade which has defensive characteristics and should protect portfolios in a broader risk-off shock. That's it from me. See you next time.